All right, this is it. On December 15, 2022, GitHub is going to officially archive the Atom Text Editor project. Now, this doesn't come as a surprise to many of us because when Microsoft purchased GitHub for $7.5 billion in 2018, we knew the writing was on the wall. GitHub created the Atom Text Editor back in 2014, released it in about 2015, and Microsoft has VS Code. So when Microsoft acquired GitHub, it didn't make sense for them to have two different text editors to be working on. So developers knew back then that the time was coming when Atom would no longer exist. But the question was when? When would that happen? Well, GitHub, within the past couple of months, released an article, a blog post, stating that they're going to be sunsetting the Atom Text Editor on December 15th of 2022. And the reason for this is because they want to focus their attention on other developer tools that are going to be housed in the cloud. Of course, a lot of time and attention has been spent on VS Code. There's VS Code for the web, there's Codespaces. There's a lot of projects that they're working on. And if you notice, there's been very little development happening with Atom itself. And GitHub mentions that in their article. They say that there hasn't been any major features added to Atom within the past few years. Now, how many people does this impact? How many developers still use the Atom Text Editor? If you take a look at the 2021 developer survey conducted by Stack Overflow, you're gonna see that roughly about 13% of the 80,000 respondents said they still use the Atom Text Editor. Now, it doesn't seem like a lot. That's just about 10,000 maybe developers, but that's from that survey. If you then take a look at how many developers are there in the world, how many millions of developers are there in the world, and then you take 13% of that number, now we're talking about a very large portion of the developer community, millions of people who will no longer be able to use their favorite text editor. Now, a lot of people might say, well, it's not that big of a deal. There's a lot of different text editors that you can use. I mean, seriously, the list goes on and on about how many text editors and IDEs are out there. But as a developer, as a programmer, as a coder, we all know that the choices that we make within what tools we use, they can be very personal. And we could get very attached to the tools that we use. I mean, think about it. What operating system do you use? Are you a Linux user, Windows, or macOS? What programming language do you code in? Are you a PHP developer, Python, JavaScript, Java, C++? What frameworks and libraries do you like to use? What web browser do you use if you're testing out your web project? What programming paradigm do you code in? Are you an object-oriented programmer, procedural, or functional? And then one that gets a lot of debate is, are you a spaces or tabs type of person? Now, when it comes to the text editor, think about it. We spend a lot of time learning the different features and functionality of the text editors that we use. How can we extend them? How can we make them ours, customize them? We spend a lot of time learning the keyboard shortcuts of these editors so we can be a more efficient coder, programmer. So yeah, when one of our favorite tools gets taken off the market, the pain can be real. One of the good things is that some of these other editors and IDEs, you can import your key bindings, your shortcuts, and some of your settings from one editor to the other. So that kind of takes away the pain point of changing up your workflow, learning a new editor, things of that nature. But this is why I follow a personal philosophy when it comes to the tools I use. I like to hedge my bets. I like to learn a couple of different tools. That's why I often code on Windows, macOS, and Linux. That's why I like learning how to use different developer tools of web browsers. And that's why when it comes to the text editor I use, yes, I use Atom a lot. But I also do use VS Code. And if you take a look at some of my videos, you're going to see that the majority of them, I demonstrate how to code with VS Code. And that's because it is also free and easy to use. And it's used by the vast majority of people, according to the developer survey from Stack Overflow. Now, the interesting thing is that Atom came out first, right? Atom was the first project that used what's called the Electron Framework, which is what you use when you want to make a cross-platform compatible computer application or computer software. Atom was the first, and then came a bunch of other different projects, and VS Code is one of them. So what comes next? Since Atom is being discontinued, since it's being abandoned by GitHub, is there going to be another alternative? As I mentioned, there's a bunch of alternatives out there. Seriously, I mean, take a look at, you know, how many alternatives are out there, and you are going to see an endless list. But there's going to be a new kid on the block, and it's called Zed. and it's from the original coders and programmers of the Atom Text Editor. These programmers are no longer with GitHub, but they're the ones that worked on the Atom project while there. So now they're gonna take everything they learned when creating the Atom editor, and they're gonna be incorporating it into a new text editor that's gonna be lightning fast, it's gonna be open source, and I'm assuming it's gonna be very similar in terms of usability to the Atom text editor. So sound off, let me know what you think about this change coming about in the developer community, where we are literally losing one of the tools that a lot of us use. Does it impact you? Does it not impact you? Did you even know it was happening? What are your thoughts and opinions? Leave them down in the comment section below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel, hit that notification icon, and share this video with others. As always, thanks for watching and happy coding.